Hello everyone, this is Anupam this side. So in my previous video, we have learned how to use SourceTree with Bitbucket. So now, and we have also learned some basic steps of Git, like how to take a commit, how to take a clone from remote repository to local repository, and how to use pull command, how to use push command, and how to push our code to the remote repository code. So now today in this video we will learn how conflict occurs. Actually, conflict occurs when two separate branches have made edits to the same line in a file, or when a file is deleted in one branch and be edited in other by other. Conflicts will most likely happen when working in a team environment. So to understand the how to conflict occurs, so now we have some basic analogy to understand how conflict occurs. So suppose if we have a two branch, branch 2 and branch 3, and we have cut the branch from master, two branches, branch 2 and branch 3. So the basic common ancestor would be master. So source content, suppose if I have made changes in branch 3, in second line I will write 3, and other developer will make the changes in branch 2 with writing 2. If he will raise a PR and I will raise a PR to master branch, so Git will confuse which content we will keep. Suppose I will edit 3 and he is made edit 2, or Git will confuse. So that conflict arise in this situation. So let's see some in SourceTree with practical example. Like suppose if I have this file readme.txt file, and if I made changes in this line, suppose if I made these changes, I will learn how conflict arise . So I have made changes in this readme.txt file in line number 11. So I will save. If I will go to SourceTree, then immediately I will see that there is some changes in readme.txt file. So if I will stage, first I will have to stage before going to commit. And I will commit, I will local commit these changes. So local commit, so I will have to some informative message like that. Added new line number 11 in readme file. So basically I will do first local commit. So it is asking me to code, this code is going to push on the server, but so how conflict occurs, I made some changes on the server. It is like that other developers have made their changes on this file with same line. So now in later video, we'll see how to use multiple branches, and we will request a PR to merge in same branch. But now we will see. Okay, it is loading. So it will be loading in a second. So suppose this readme file, readme.txt file, because we are using this edited in same branch. This is a master branch. So suppose I have also added one more line here. It is taking time to load. So developer B has made changes in line 11. Okay, so basically this is a descriptive message to understand what is going on in this current readme.txt file. So I will commit this code. Basically this code is committed directly to the server. So added line number 11 by developer B. We can say B is like that, is a abbreviation, like we can A, B, C, D. So for understanding, so I mention here B. Create a pull request for this change. Actually, I will understand about these changes like that. If we are going to merge in a production, so we'll have to create a PR, and then other team members and other team lead will review our code. Then they will approve. Then we will eligible for merging these changes to master branch. So before skip this section. Now we commit this code to understand first how to conflict arise in same branches. So developer B has made their changes in same files. So now going to the source tree. So we are working on same branch, so it is asking me to get a, so this is a best practice to get updated content. It is taking some time as it is taking the internet connection, because of internet connection. Fetching is like that, it is getting updated content what we have made changes on the server, let us server with same branches. So it is taking some time to get no changes. Okay, we are done. So source tree is indicating us like that you have to take a pull. You have made some changes in same branches. So this is general practice. Developer comes for a work, so that he will have to take some pull. If any other had made their changes in same branches, so this is a general practice. I will do the same. So I am taking a pull from remote server. It is taking some time because I think internet connection. Oh, oops. Let's see this pop-up. What is saying that you now have merge conflict in your working copy that need to be resolved before continuing. You can do this by selecting the conflict files and using the option under the resolve conflicts. So this is the example how conflict occurs, because other developer have made the changes in same lines and we have already changes in same file with same line number 11 close. So you will see that. So now you will see that head is like that. Now I am working on head is my branch, and this developer B has made changes in line number 11. So Git will be confused what line number we should keep in this line. So in source tree there is an option, if we right click on that, resolve conflict. Resolve conflict, you will see that resolve using mine, resolve using theirs. Resolve using mine, that you will keep mine changes, and other you want to keep their changes. Their changes means developer B has made changes in line number 11. So I will keep here resolve using mine. So resolve using mine. So my changes has been left in this file. So I will commit these changes, and their changes has been gone with resolve conflict. So I will do the commit, and source tree is asking to me push the those changes to the server. I will refresh here. What changes have been updated here? So I will go to the source options to see the updated changes. So we remember we have done the changes with mine changes. Yes. So 11. So then this is updated. I will learn how conflict arise. This is the mine changes which have been updated here, because I have updated from resolve conflict mine options from source tree there. So this is the example how do conflict arise and how will conflict resolve. So this is the same branch we are working on. We are understanding how to conflict occurs and how conflict arise. So basically, let's understand some other concept like that. So please, if we click on Git flow, create use following branches, production branch, development branch, use the following prefix in future. Like that, generally we do in some practice if we are working on a good product and good project. Like that, if we have to release, so that we have some master branch, development branch is working on a 2 or 3 developers. So they need to create a branch from master branch. So they have to work on their develop branch. We have to use some tagging system like prefix. Suppose I am working on one feature. I have to develop some payment feature. So today I have assigned to some task like that. You have to work on payment feature. So there is a develop branch. So I will create a feature branch from develop branch, and with naming like that feature payment feature functionality. So and other developer is also working on other showing the listing. So he will have to create from feature branch from development branch. So there are multiple feature branch, and end of the day it is going to be need to merge on develop branch. Hotfix branch prefix means, if suppose you have delivered your product and from master branch and in production there is bug arises, so you have to cut the branch from master branch and fix that branch from hotfix to master and deliver the product from master. Version tag prefix is like that, if we have a multiple version of a one product like 1.0, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. So this is indicating like that if we have a chain system, this is my 1.0 release, this is my 1.1 release. So basically we can use tag system also. So first of now we will learn how to create a branch from local and push to the server. It is taking some time because I think internet connectivity is not good. So if I'm going to create a branch, so like that if I'm working on some feature, add new text file. Actually this is basic example from add new text file. Other so we can show other demo like that if you are working on a good big project and big product. This is like a small and for understanding how to things work in Git. So basically so this branch is basically current branch, develop branch. Master develop is creating by default if I click on Git flow. So I will have to create a branch from master. So feature, basically best practice is that we have to create branch from develop branch from master, but for now understanding I am creating a feature branch from here, because master branch have some content from readme.txt file. So I will have to add another file here. So add new file, create branch. Feature branch is like that. So now I am in a feature branch. So suppose in readme.txt file I will add another file here, text document feature file 1. So I have do some changes here. I have added feature file 1. I will save the changes. So you will see that you have assigned some work and you update some files, edit some files. So you will see here along with readme.txt file which you have seen on master branch. So now you have to add this file with stage selected. This is in unstage option. So now you have made changes in file and now you have to commit those changes in add new file. Added new files in feature branch. So it is like that I have assigned to work on, have to work on feature file 1. So you have made some changes on feature file 1 and you have pushed your changes in feature branch, commit branch. So now added new file, and if you have to push these changes to the server, so there will be some changes to your server. So this is basically branch created from local. If you want to push into the server, that you just need to click on check on the feature add new file, push. For now it is not updating, but if we push the section, that it is pushing feature add new file. You will see that 40 seconds ago added new files in feature branch. So basically I have created one branch from local, do some changes in local. After that I will realize that I have done my work, so I will push my changes on the server. So now there is one feature branch, there is one master branch. So I need to push my changes, I need to merge my changes feature branch from to master branch. So this is basically we call pull request. Create pull request is like that. I want to merge my feature changes into master branch. Feature branch to master branch. So I have to write some informative message here. I have made some changes in feature branch and going to merge in master branch. So basically attachment is, if you want to attach some files here, add reviewer is like that. If you want to add some reviewers in your teammates, that they will have some review and give their feedbacks, what are changes is going to good or not, like that. Suppose you have made changes in this file and you have done some mistakes, so that other team members will have some suggestions to that, please correction in these changes, like that. So basically currently I am doing myself for learning purpose, to making some videos to contribute my learning to other people. So basically there is create pull request. I will create this pull request, close. So for now I will create this pull request. I cannot add reviewers here. So reviewers can now request changes. Okay, so suppose that if you would have two or more reviewers, so they would review the changes like that. If they feel like that this file is not a good, so they will make some comment from here, that like that this file need some correction. So this type of comment any developers, any teammates can do after reviewing your code. So this is like that. So basically I am reviewing myself my code for understanding, for learning to you. So basically it is a process like that. Team, suppose you have team leads and architecture, so they will some suggestions what you have done in your feature branch before going to merge in production. So basically they will do some comments, and you will have to some correction after that and update your code in existing PR request. Basically, we say it is like that pull request when we are going to merge one branch into another branch. So basically, I will approve because I am doing myself. There is no other person with me. So it has been approved. A reviewer has been done and it is going to merge. So I will merge this branch into master branch. So basically this branch has been merged into master branch. You will see that changes. Feature file 1. Wow. Now you have two branches. Added new file, feature branch is like that. You have made changes in their features. Suppose that you are working in a big project and you will have assigned some payment feature. So you have done some work on payment feature and update the code, commit the code in feature branches. Now that you will have to raise some PR request to going to merge on master. So other your team members and other team reviewers will review your code and give some suggestion. After feedback of their suggestion, you will have to work on that. And after that, if they approve their code, that they will merge your code to the production branch. So now we have merged this master branch. I hope you understand how to create a feature branch, how to create a PR request, how to merge PR request to master branch, and how to resolve conflict. I hope you all have learned these things. So I will continue to making such videos to learning my learning skills to contribute other people's. So now we have done. In next video we will go for another learning skills like Git about and how to upload the build from app centers, how to define CI/CD process using Bitbucket. So